Consciousness expanded. Exhausted. Map updated. Resource acquired. The Dark Infection. Pathogen Xeno-71b is a mutagenic infectious compound. Unlike most diseases, this pathogen is able to infect any biological material it comes into contact with, regardless of how alien. Furthermore, it is able to assimilate surrounding material into its biological matrix. Living flesh and technology can become fused, both physically and in function. Given enough time, an infected starship will become a unified entity of biomass and circuitry, absent of any crew. The abominated ships exhibit a basic understanding of the systems and technology they have assimilated, suggesting a form of intelligence. It is known the infection source originates from the dark entity, but it is not clear if the self-preserving intelligence is inherent or telepathically communicated by the dark entity. Added to cargo hold. Exhausted.
It is absolute murder to me when we have unused analytical data like this. Unless you wish to fall asleep one night and never wake up, you'll make haste and allocate this data at once.
Thank you.
We may have a galaxy-wide shortage of res, but we certainly don't have a shortage of poor saps combing the void looking for more. All the potent res fields have been catalogued, yet every so often someone finds an oasis of the stuff. It's not exactly legal to be harvesting it without the proper drilling equipment, but who's enforcing that? Exactly. We might as well drop in and take our pound of flesh too.
Relay point dead. Map updated. Scanning area.
We may have a galaxy-wide shortage of...
Engaging. Target lost. Obliterating. Relay point obliterated. Engaging. Relay point. Engaging. Obliterating.
I try not to start fights I can't win, but everyone makes mistakes. It's not beneath me to use one of those silly fail gates if the situation should call for it. Just remember, we're going to have to dump some cargo and leave our strike craft behind if we do so.
Acquired. Thank you.
Virus expanded.
As humanity saturated the cosmos, new means of communication and documentation needed to be invented. While warp gates were a surefire way to transport matter, it was not very economical for communication needs. Without the forces exerted by solid matter, transmissions got lost in the warp stream, arriving late or being relayed to a random gate. Some worlds adapted warp beacons as mail carriers, but these often got raided by bandits or converted into spam bots. As the population continued to expand, so did the vast distance between worlds. While each world keeps a record of their own occurrences, many of the founding worlds have been destroyed, along with the rich history they once knew. Significant events such as the discovery of Rez remain rooted as common knowledge. However, it is impossible to determine exactly when these events may have occurred or for what duration.
Signal detected.
Alert! Super ultra hot bunking detected. There is too much meat aboard. Consider selling human lives in exchange for something of value.
Area exhausted.
Human history is riddled with examples of reoccurring themes, throwbacks, revolutions, and revelations. One such reoccurrence is the use of colorful metaphors to heighten one's emotional resonance. While it had been commonplace for even kindergarten children to swear and curse for nearly a millennia, it has recently become taboo. The Anti-Potty Mouth Initiative is a communal-funded program aimed at refining the human language, while increasing speaking efficiency by removing filler slang. The initiative overall has been very successful, while the proposed gore and violence reduction program has not received a single vote. The Friends Don't Shoot Friends in the Face program is not even expected to make it to the voting phase. Extracted. Resource acquired. Added to cargo hold. Scanning area. Extracted. Area exhausted. Awareness expanded. Game signal detected. Thank you.
resource acquired. Added to cargo hold. Following the Dark Infection, a few scientists established a group dedicated to the investigation of the Dark Entity. They reached out to the best and brightest survivors the Void had to offer. Unfortunately, they were plagued by constant bandit attacks until they enacted a minimal contact policy with other factions. Now, they cling to life like the rest of the galaxy, having all but given up on the scientific endeavors it was founded upon. Map updated. Scanning area. Extracted. Dr. Carl Memford has had a long and colorful history of mental instability, despite having an uncanny level of intelligence. Though he is physically harmless, he has worked on several controversial UTA projects, including the now discontinued lockdown vaccination for children. After a short time on the run, he discovered Don Gibson and the massive clockwork ship he was building. Appalled by obvious design flaws, he offered his services as head engineer. Though the rest of the crew is perpetually annoyed by his horrific manner, he proved to be indispensable in helping reach the core and destroying the Dark Entity. Signal detected.
Popular demand, more scheduled combat drills. Now that we have some decent weapons, let's cut our teeth on a live fire exercise. As in, we'll be shooting at living things. Now before you get your long johns in a bunch, listen. We're simply gonna rub out a few bandits. I'm gonna find a suitable target, and we're gonna find out what this ship is made of.
I could have sworn I was captain of this ship yesterday. This has got to be the last examination. You do remember we saved the entire galaxy, don't you?
If there is one thing I've learned about people, is that they have infinite ambition to do as little as possible. Your brain might be a muscle, but so is your trigger finger. If you don't practice, your trigger finger might forget all the things it once knew.
What? Okay, whatever. Let's just get this over with. I don't like to keep too many murders in my inbox.
Game saved.
You can never reason with a bandit. In fact, I don't think they even understand a basic language. They pretty much stomp around, raping and pillaging anything that moves. Having one foot in the grave already, most of them are little threat to us. That said, I've heard rumors of colossal bandit ships more times than I can ignore. Trash pile or otherwise, we should respect and acknowledge their potential threat before we look for trouble with these potato-brained psychos.
Okay, point, shoot, kill. And don't look down the business end of the boomstick, you got that? If you don't, I'll get you a life jacket for the next time you use the toilet.
Engaging.
Blown something up. Jameson, did you get your fix? Don't even answer that. And don't give us any homework assignments either. Let's just pack it up. I have a bug up my aft to maybe, you know, save the bloody universe. Do we think we can squeak that into our busy grade school schedule?
Look at all this here stuff all tossed about the void like toilet paper in the wind. As much as I want to stuff the metal mother full of treasure, the space inside is always smaller than the shell outside. Go figure.
Engaging. Battle wagon mode. activated. Relay point designated. Relay point designated. Disengaging.
If you wish to succeed in this universe, we need more data. My body needs it. Kill to get it if you must. Bring me the data, and I will give you power beyond your wildest dreams.
Game saved.
Offline.
I have already willingly and graciously volunteered to do all the real work aboard this ship. All that is required from you is to simply select a button and press it. Just do not press it too hard.
Thank you.
Engaging.
Somehow, for some void-forsaken reason, the galaxy isn't quite violent enough for some people. That's why we have simulation arenas. They kind of work like a mind-rotting video game, giving homicidal psychopaths a safe environment to practice. It might not be such a bad idea if we gave it a go. I know it hurts, but we just might learn something, and maybe earn a few slivers of scrap for our troubles.
Resource acquired. Awareness expanded. When humanity began colonization of the cosmos, a central government feebly attempted to maintain order across the countless worlds. As expansion continued, central government was unable to enforce any laws. Interplanetary diseases ran amok. Worlds became savage as they realized they lived in a lawless state. Nearby worlds began raiding each other for resources without any fear of legal recourse. The United Terran Alliance was founded to bring the dissident worlds into the fold and halt the interplanetary pandemics. Where a democratic government failed, a military one would succeed it. The first stage was isolation. The warp gates were temporarily shut down and encoded with access keys only the UTA controlled. This kept worlds from attacking each other, while the UTA systematically set up individual government cells on each world. Area exhausted. The breach incident occurred when the first Titan Gate was successfully bypassed by an unregistered traveler, ending the lockdown wars. Though no infected vessels were ever able to escape through the breach, it was widely publicized as the cause of the infection itself. Unbeknownst to the general public at the time, the infection had ravaged the core worlds for centuries beforehand. The breach became a UTA scapegoat to cover up years of concealed conflict. Signal detected. Area exhausted. Extracted. Resource acquired. Scanning area. Area exhausted.
updated. Resource acquired. Game saved. Signal detected.
Mode.
activated.
Sleeping, I connected the data analyzer system to your cerebral cortex. If you select the incorrect button, your brain functions will cease and you will die. No pressure.
Target locked. Obliterated. Shields offline. The Sun Hunters originally began as a nomadic bounty hunters guild during the Dark Infection. When the warp gates fell, so did the feasibility of tracking targets across the galaxy for credits. They slowly congregated together in a small corner of the galaxy to form the Sun Hunters. In hopes of warding off attacks from other factions, they maintained the fierce imagery of their predecessors' ships and starbases.